Hey everyone, we know that some devices like USB pens are plug and play. You just plug them in, Windows should pop up and work absolutely fine with them. In some cases, although Windows can be a bit buggy, but in general, a USB pen is plug and play. But what about a CPU? Can you buy a new CPU, put that on your motherboard, and then, you know, restart your computer and everything is just hunky-dory? Well, maybe or maybe not. And I know that's an annoying answer, but bear with me for just 2 minutes while I outline everything you need to know. So basically, assuming that your CPU is the same socket as your motherboard, you know, so if you've got an AM5 motherboard, you need to make sure that, you know, your CPU is AM5 too and all that. Assuming that that is fine, then what'll happen is you put your new CPU in, and everything should boot up fine. Although I should point out that if your motherboard is an older BIOS version, you might need to update it if you've got the very latest CPU. You know, if you've got a 9000 series CPU and like a B650 motherboard, then yeah, you might need to update the BIOS to actually get that 9000 series support. But assuming that's all in place, then yeah, you know, upgrading from like a 7000 series to a 9000 series CPU should be absolutely fine. You could just boot up and it should work absolutely fine. And as a result, it is plug and play. But what can sometimes happen is the system can take a few minutes to actually boot back up as part of the new post process, because some motherboards might actually detect that there's been that change. And sometimes, you know, the motherboard will actually pop up saying there's been a hardware change, you need to enter the BIOS to confirm or something like that. And actually, sometimes you might be waiting for like your main monitor to pop up. It's actually, if you've got more than one monitor, it might be that the output is going to like the HDMI for that BIOS warning or something like that. So just double check that. You know, if you've got two monitors, one with HDMI, it might be that you need to turn that other monitor on to see that warning. But in general, once you boot it up, Windows doesn't usually complain about just changing the CPU. It might download new drivers, and you know, either AMD software will pop up with new chipset drivers, or Windows Update will install new drivers. In general, it should be fine. In very rare cases, Windows might become deactivated and say there's been a hardware change, but often you can go into the settings and click a button saying, you know, yes, I've changed some hardware, and it should work absolutely fine. Like, I changed my CPUs quite a lot, and I've never actually had Windows deactivate itself in a way where I can't easily, you know, reactivate it. But yeah, that is something to know, is Windows could do that. But in general, changing a CPU is plug and play. But what isn't plug and play is if you change your motherboard and your CPU. Like, I tried that one time, and I tried keeping my Windows install on for my NVMe drive because I didn't want to change that. And basically what happened was my system booted back up as normal, but then basically Windows Update kicked in and installed loads of Windows updates. And then when I rebooted, everything was completely bricked. I couldn't get back into Windows because everything was in a corrupt state. You know, that Windows install was installed on actually an AM4 chipset. And then, you know, I basically upgraded it to AM5, and Windows just got completely corrupted after that Windows update. And in that case, you know, if you're changing the CPU and the motherboard and going with a new socket or new generation or whatever else, then things won't be plug and play, and it might be better to just reinstall Windows as part of that. So that pretty much wraps things up. But if you've got any further questions, please let me know down in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.